content of the following program is not intended to be a substitute for professional medical advice, diagnosis, treatment, or cure. Always consult your physician or a health professional with any questions you may have regarding a medical condition. Want to go higher, baby? You're in the right place. You're listening to One Life Radio. This is Bernadette with Anthony Cernelia. I've got Lexi in studio with me, Aviana. I've got Autumn Connolly and Dr. Mike McFarland. Hey, everyone. How are you doing today?
Doing great.
Good.
I'm a little green around the gills, but I'm fighting it. A lot of stress. But I think, Stress does kind of stress can make you sick, can't it?
Without a doubt, yes. Yeah. It affects your immune system.
Yep. Yep.
And even if it's not affecting your immune system, when you get stressed out, a lot of times it will impact, your sense of well-being. Mm-hmm. It can certainly affect your stomach, make you nauseated.
Yeah. I think I compassionately got sick or whatever. What do you call that when, someone you love is sick and then you get
sympathy?
What is it?
Yeah, sympathetic.
Yeah, sympathetic. Because my daughter couldn't come home this weekend from OU because she's had strep throat.
Oh, no.
And I was like, well, you can't give it to me, Mm-hmm. I don't think I have strep throat, but I have kind of weak lungs. They've got a lot of scar tissue from having pneumonia many, many times. So Autumn brought me one of her special brews over there to doctor me up with good bacteria.
That's right. A lot of it.
Well, for those of you just now joining us, and maybe aren't familiar with Autumn or Dr. Mike McFarland, Autumn is a self-taught vegan cook. She is a mom of two, a researcher of all natural remedies, an animal lover. She teaches free meditation and yoga classes. She has even written a children's book, and she is the inventor of Ether Elixir. You can find her at probioticsyall.com. And Dr. Mike McFarland, he is a PhD, and he is a licensed psychologist in the state of Texas with a private practice here in Dallas. Dr. Mike provides individual therapy to adolescents through adulthood, and he specializes in the treatment of anxiety disorders, obsessive compulsive spectrum disorders, and male body image and eating disorders. And you can find Dr. McFarland at McFarlandPsychology.com. I love the topics that we're talking about today. They are so juicy.
Yeah, I'm curious.
They really are. So we're going to be talking about birth control and something I know a lot about. Most women do that have gone, their entire life trying not to get pregnant. It's scary. And men don't have to deal with it. What's up with that?
Well, I mean, men bear some responsibility, but yes, the burden usually ends up falling on women.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. And with you, we're talking about recognizing rapid-onset gender dysphoria. I can barely read it. I don't even know what it means. What is it?
Well, it's gonna be an interesting topic. Gender dysphoria and transgenderism are pretty prevalent topics right now in America. Mm-hmm. And so this is a new way of looking at gender dysphoria. It's very early in its research, but yeah. I think it's going to be interesting.
Well, I was being somewhat facetious. I don't think you could be on the planet and not have heard of this, but it is, I still don't understand it. I don't understand what causes it, what really determines whether or not it's real, but you've got some strong opinions about it. So there was an article, Everything You Need to Know About Rapid Onset Gender Dysphoria. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
And that's kind of an oppositional article mm-hmm. to the research that I'm going to be talking about during the segment. That basically puts out the idea of rapid onset gender dysphoria in contrast to just sort of gender dysphoria mm-hmm. and explains circumstances that might be precipitating a very rapid onset of questioning of your gender identity.
Yeah.
And, it really resonated with me when I read that article, even though, as I said, it's the first research article that sort of puts out there that there's a specific subtype. But I also talked about it with a lot of my peers. And my peers who work with adolescents, we've all experienced what they're describing in this article.
Mm-hmm.
So It's going to be kind of controversial because certainly it goes against the grain of the gender affirmative therapy and the viewpoint that's being sort of propagated by the mental health community.
Mm-hmm.
But that's why it merits some additional attention.
Yeah. Well, it's funny because, you know, Lexi's carrying her first child. And, of course, they had the gender reveal. Mm-hmm. And it was a boy. And it is a boy. His name is Lil Wayne.
Wayne,
but I call him Little Wayne. And we're all anxious to meet him. But, you know, the gender thing is such a big deal. It seems like,
sure.
And why is it so focused on gender? I don't think it, I don't know. I don't think it serves anybody well when you put too much focus on any one gender being, I don't know, what do I want to say here? Better than the other one? Mm-hmm. Or if the baby is born and it's homosexual, and now we're getting into some really controversial stuff mm-hmm. here. I'm on a very conservative station. What determines that? A lot of people have a lot of different opinions about it.
Yes, and you can look at it from sort of a scientific or research perspective. And, you know, the scientific consensus on something like homosexuality mm-hmm. is that it is a combination of genetic predispositions and environmental influences through the course of life, you mm-hmm. know, especially in the early years. Now, if you go from a political sort of an activist or social justice position, you're going to hear it's genetic, it's genetic, it's genetic. So again, controversial. Different mm-hmm. different constituencies have different perspectives.
Yeah.
And research is sometimes different from rhetoric.
Right.
And ideology.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're not the only species, if I'm not mistaken, that homosexuality exists.
Sure.
It's not just a human being thing. There are other species that it happens in, and it's not like it should be something that we think differently about a person, in my opinion, whatever their sexual preference is really none of our business at the end of the day. Would you agree, you guys? Autumn?
Oh, for sure. Yeah, my kids are recently... We've got a couple of friends who have two moms or two dads, and they only really recently started asking me about it. And I'm just, you know, I'm like, love's mm-hmm. love. And they're like, okay, like that's all it took.
Yeah. No, that's true. Love is love. And why do we have to define it? Why do we have to put it in a box? Why do we have to have, in this case, gender? So, you know, to define that gender as being correct or not correct, mm-hmm. incorrect, I guess would be the right way to say it instead of not correct. But do you know what I'm saying?
Sure.
Like, we don't get a right to do that, in my opinion. It is what it is. I don't know if I can tell the story, but it's actually a beautiful one. A friend of a friend of mine, we'll say a friend of a friend of a friend, just so nobody can identify who it is. But recently, divorced her husband, okay? And it's kind of funny. I don't know why. Let me be very careful what I put out here. But he was gay. Okay, mm-hmm. and he had hidden it for many years. And when they divorced, and he finally, came out of the closet. Isn't that the term that they use? Mm-hmm. Is there another term that they use? I don't like that term.
Well, they just came out. You could just
they just came out mm-hmm. and spoke their truth. And now he is a happy person. He is living his life to the fullest. And so instead of turning it into something ugly, they turned it into something beautiful, which I personally think is beautiful, because you can't go back and change that person's sexual preference. You have to embrace it. And so in doing so, especially where children are involved, you don't ever want to look down at that person because they might not, you might not agree with what their sexual preference is. Am I making sense here?
Sure.
So they turned it into this really beautiful thing, mm-hmm. like this really beautiful thing that your father now has basically, it's an awakening instead of this horrible secret that he's been keeping for years and been miserable behind the scenes emotionally and mentally. And I just think I thought it was so beautiful the way it was represented to mm-hmm. the children.
Mm-hmm.
And so...
It's a great story.
It is a great story, mm-hmm. isn't it?
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be a negative, dirty, awful thing, you know, like so many people, want to gossip and talk about it. It's not. It's a good thing.
I do think that anytime you have a spouse and a family involved, you know, that kind of a revelation is going to have effects.
A huge impact.
And they're not all going to be positive.
Right,
you know,
right.
And we have to be prepared to support the children.
Right.
Support the entire family system
yes.
through that transition.
Well, and that's the thing. It was huge for the children, and it
yeah.
was a shock.
Sure.
But it doesn't have to be a bad shock, because the way it is represented, You know, the way it is presented, I guess, is what I wanted to say. The way it was presented, the way it was understood with the children, that this is not a bad thing. This truth needed to come out.
Right.
In a lot of ways, though, it's like any, you know, any truth or any undoing of a relationship. You know, if you couch it in the right light to children, you know, they're, children are pretty receptive and they're very accepting, too, of, you know, different lifestyles and behaviors. So rather than it just being a sexual preference, you know, it could just be, you know, mommy and daddy like doing different things or this or that.
Yeah.
You know, it's a
Well, also the age appropriateness of how much information do you share based on, you know, the children's development. So you can share more with an older child than you're going to want to share with, say, a 5 or a 6 year old.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, interesting stuff. I can't wait to talk all about this. Everyone, we've got a great show coming up with Autumn Connolly and Dr. Mike McFarland, PhD. We're going to be talking about birth control and gender dysphoria. Stay tuned. You're listening to One Life Radio.
Consider this an invitation to relax and feel the stress melt away with a Sunlighten sauna. Sunlighten is the number one choice for home and commercial infrared saunas. Their 3-in-1 infrared technology allows you to customize each session to you. Naturally de-stress, detoxify, and be heart healthy. Relieve pain, purify your skin, and increase energy. A Sunlighten sauna is a place to heal, a place to reflect, a place to invest in you. Visit them at sunlighten.com.
Hi, I'm Ashley Grace, co-founder of H-Hemp Company. Hemp CBD improved my life so much that I started a company to help others naturally feel better. You don't have to have had a severe brain injury like me to benefit from H-Hemp Company products. If you're struggling to feel better, calm your brain, or better deal with daily stress and want to do so naturally, please try H-Hemp Company products. Search H-Hemp Company and use code OLR for 20% off and free shipping. That's H-Hemp Company and code OLR to feel better naturally and calm your brain.
Hi, everyone. This is Bernadette. Do you know why I love Paleo Magazine? Paleo Magazine was founded with the purpose of providing readers with the information they need to live strong, vibrant, healthy lives. They are dedicated to partnering with leaders in the paleo community to spread the knowledge of ancestral health principles without the influence of big pharma or big agriculture. Paleo Magazine. Follow them on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and Instagram, or visit them at paleomagonline.com. That's paleomagonline.com.
Give your body some soul with Sun Warrior's new Soul Good Protein Bars. Sun Warrior is committed to making the best plant-based proteins and superfood supplements from the finest organic ingredients across the globe. Soul Good Bars have an amazing profile. They have 17 to 19 grams of clean organic protein, very low sugar, and 16 to 17 grams of fiber. They're available in delicious flavors like blueberry blast, coconut cashew, cinnamon roll, and salted caramel. Check them out online at sunwarrior.com. That's sunwarrior.com. And give your adventure some soul.
Thank you for that, Anthony Cernelia. He's on the music and in the control room. Welcome back to One Life Radio, everyone. I want to let you know that you can go to our website, oneliferadio.com, to download and listen to our podcast or our podcast after the broadcast, or subscribe to our newsletter. Go to iHeartMedia.com to listen live from your mobile device and download the free iHeartRadio app and listen to us from anywhere in the world. A big shout out to our sponsors that bring this programming to you. Great, great companies like Sun Warrior. Get Sun Warrior at Vitamin Shop or put it in your smoothie at Smoothie King. Sun Warrior is a premium all-natural raw superfood company dedicated to providing the best vegan plant-based protein powders and supplements. And of course, the H-Hemp Company. Use the code OLR for 20% off your first order, made only with premium hemp cannabinoid genetics, not hemp used for seeds, protein, or rope. And of course, the Sunlighten Infrared Saunas. It is a place to heal, a place to reflect, and a place to invest in you. I absolutely love mine. You can check them out at Nebraska Furniture Mart. I believe they sell them at those stores through Texas. I don't know if Nebraska Furniture Mart is national or not.
I'm not sure.
But here in Dallas, you can check them out. And I got my new copy copy of Paleo Magazine. You can visit them at paleomagonline.com to find a store near you and pick up a copy. It's beautiful. On the cover are Casavana waffles with honey. Look how delicious that looks. And I think pistachios, but
wow.
Always great, great articles in here. So many great articles, so many great recipes. And I'm looking forward to reading it and having a couple of their experts on the air with us. And, of course, the Well-Being Journal, same thing. Great publication.